Monsoon calls for comfort food, and comfort food for me is anything deep fried. If not for my arteries, I would eat deep fried every day. Today I present to you very crunchy, tasty and yummy onion rings. This is not the traditional onion ring recipe, but with a little bit of twist, which we'll cover later. And not to forget, these are gluten free, so let's get started. Let's start by cutting this onion into half in slices. I have a white onion here, but you can use yellow or red onion too. Make sure to not slice them too thin, otherwise there won't be enough room for the batter to stick. Now let's season this onion slices with salt and pepper. Make sure to season it on both the sides. I have a sauté pan running on medium heat here. I'm now going to add some vegetable oil. Just sauté these onions for 10-15 seconds on both the sides. I don't want the raw onion flavor. I want the flavor with more depth. Don't overcook them. I still want the rings to hold their shape and not wilt away. Now that our onions are lightly roasted, I'm going to plate them. I'm now going to put them in the fridge for approximately 30 minutes until they're completely chilled. Now that our onions have chilled completely, I'm going to dab off the excess oil. The oil is going to prevent the batter from sticking, so that's necessary. We'll now separate the rings and lightly coat it with corn flour. Now the all important step, our batter for deep frying. We'll start by adding equal proportion of rice flour and corn flour. Now goes in our main ingredient, which is nothing but the xanthan gum. Xanthan gum is a natural food additive and will help the batter stick to the onion rings a little better. It will also help the batter repel oil so that our onion rings don't become that oily. It's very reasonably priced and it's easily available on Amazon. We're going to use this in many more recipes in the future, so this is worth an investment. You need a very small portion, maybe just 1% of the total proportion of your both the flours. Here I have added approximately only 1 gram. Give it a mix. Now whisk in some club soda. I don't want the batter to be too thin or too thick. I just want a pancake batter and a dosa batter like consistency. Also, do not over mix, it will lose all the carbonation from our soda. Now on to our final step. We have a pot of oil running on medium high heat. It's now time to get frying. We have now deep fried them for approximately 4 to 5 minutes until they are light brown. The thing with this recipe is that it does not have any all-purpose flour or maida, and you won't get that typical golden brown color. But trust me, once you taste this, you'll find them lot more crunchier and crispier and tastier, and color won't matter no more. Season it with salt and chaat masala. I can't wait to taste this. Absolutely crunchy and very delicious. You're absolutely going to be in love with this. Can't have the perfect onion rings without the perfect dipping sauce. So making a dipping sauce. For that I have some mayonnaise. To that I'm going to add my green capsicum, red capsicum, orange capsicum, whatever you have, some green chilies, dill, finely chopped dill leaves, some parsley, going to add a pinch of sugar, and some vinegar, white wine vinegar. Just mix this. Thank you for watching Isha's Kitchen. If you like this recipe, please do give it a try and tag me on Instagram. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel if you haven't subscribed. Until next time, this is Isha Thakkar signing off. Bye-bye.